And IFBB show. It's called the Battle of the Bodies, and it's the first ever show for Janet Layug and her production team. And as you'll see by the footage here, probably one of the coolest stages I've ever seen. It literally looks like the beach is rolling up. It looks like you're on a Gulf beach, like Clearwater or something. So that's cool because you like it when the shows have a little bit of personality, lets you know where you're at. And we have a great group of competitors, as you're going to see here in the footage. You know, we have girls from every division, from novice bikini to open bikini, master's bikini, and now we have the pros getting ready. So the fun thing about this as a coach is, like, I get to be here backstage. We're literally around the corner. The stage is right there. So we get to go through all the phases. We get to talk about, you know, poses. Ran backstage, had my one girl, you know, move her hair off her front pose so she could show her shoulders. So, you know, the sport is getting more refined. But that still means we got to pay attention to the little things. So coaching novice competitors versus coaching Olympians, it's a very different, you know, environment. What I'm focusing on with my Olympians is a lot different than what I'm focusing on with my novices, but I love every part of it. You know, I love being here and being involved. So Ricky, my man behind the camera, is going to get some great footage for you guys. It's always nice to have a videographer here with me because it's really hard for me to step out of my focus of watching the show and being, like, in the moment to pull out my camera, and I really try to do that. So for a show like this where we have 16 amazing competitors, I wanted to bring a videographer. So hopefully you guys enjoy the video. Make sure you comment below if you do, and we'll have more to come.
So you stepped on stage plenty of times. What do you think about when you're about to walk on? What are some of the thoughts that go through your head? How would you explain it to someone that's never been on stage before?
I've said this so many times, but I feel like I can't say it enough. I always remind myself to have fun. Like, that is the most important to me. I think when you've prepared enough and you've practiced your posing and you feel like you've done everything you can, left no stone unturned, the work is done. And yes, you want to take that moment seriously because it means a lot to you, but it doesn't mean as much, I think, if I'm not present and enjoying it. So I always make sure that I'm having fun up there.
And then what's one thing you want to let Paul know when he sees this?
He's thebomb.com. Freaking love that man. He is so much more than a coach now. He is family. He's been an awesome influence in my life in so many ways, and I can't thank him enough. I know he doesn't like to hear things like that. I think it makes him a little uncomfortable. But I cannot say thank you more. Like, or I can't say it enough. He's a cool dude. He's a cool freaking dude, man.
You're not right, dude.
Love you, Paul.
Skies running with the fireflies. That's where I wanna be. Climbing every mountaintop, seeing things that we could not believe. With you here next to me, that's where I wanna be. seeing things that we could not believe. With you here next to me, that's where I wanna be.
Prejudging is done here at the NPC Battle of the Bodies, IFBB Pro Battle of the Bodies, and we're thrilled with how all the girls performed. We had girls from the Novice Division, Open, Masters, all the way up into the Pro Divisions. And what was really exciting in the Pro Division, the highlight of the day was obviously Daraja Hill splitting center for the Pro Bikini title. Now, The reason this pro bikini title is so important to us is because the show is in our home state. She committed to the show months ago. She knew it was going to be Janet's first ever pro show. And Daraja really wanted to win this title for the purpose of kind of building her legacy. So ending prejudging splitting center with an amazing competitor, Maureen Blanquiso. Listen, anything can happen at finals, but we're very happy with the result from prejudging, and we'll see what happens at finals tonight. All the pro competitors, we had six total pros, did fantastic, as well as all the amateurs. So tonight, the goal is going to be have some fun, you know, celebrate all the victories, discuss all the defeats, figure out how to get better and come back. We're going to go out afterwards, have some food, have some drinks, because this sport, it's very difficult. Like, we sacrifice a lot to compete. It's a lot of time away from friends. Sometimes we get to eat the things we want, drink the things we want. But on a day like this, on a weekend like this, here in South Florida, it's gonna be great. We've got a reservation for all of us to go get something to eat after. And honestly, that's what makes this so possible for me. I'm traveling at shows almost every weekend, and it's the relationships we build, the camaraderie we have between people who are kicking butt in so many areas of life, not just on a competition stage, but that's an extension. How you do anything is how you do everything. And I promise you, these women, these men that compete, that's an extension of their life. And so now we get to go celebrate that, have fun, and talk about it amongst our friends, because let's admit it, we're the weird ones in our group friends at home, but here, it's all normal because we all have the same passion. So I'm excited for Ricky to capture these moments at finals tonight. There's gonna be some high highs, and then we're gonna go celebrate.
Did you check your butthole?
Across the country to be on this team, and since I've been on the team, my life has just 50 times has gotten better. I have such great friendship and family. I'm more driven. We're doing better in competing, and I'm so much happier. And it's because of you, because of the team you made, because of the environment that you created for all of us. And I am still feel so blessed to be a part of this team and to have you in my life. You are like my second dad. I love you. I'm trying not to cry. I go on stage and win for you. But I love you so much. You're the best. And let's just keep going.
Fifth place winner tonight in this great class. Number 38, Sharon Biscano Angelucci. Your fourth place winner, Nicole Heimel. Your third place winner, Magali Schmidt. Second place winner, number 47, Amy Valdez. This makes your Bikini Masters over 40 winner tonight. Number one, number 46, Cheryl Sweeney. Of our Class A winners, starting with fifth place, Sandra Chaparro. Fourth place, number 28, Danae Suarez. Third place, number 52, Joanna Rolfe. Your winner tonight, Sabrina Canali. Cheryl Sweeney. number 58, Brooke Caperton. Glad I asked, Nicole. Welcome your winner in this class, Nicole Hemel. Is that India Pony over there? Second place. The check for $1,500. The flowers. From Jacksonville, Daraja Hill. Those points toward the Olympia. The sportsmanship in this sport I always love, they know it already.